the story behind.
Hey, turn that down.
So unless you've been living under a rock for, I don't know, like the last 15 years, you've no doubt heard about the 2000s post-punk revival stars, The Killers, who got big back in 2004 with the release of their debut, Hot Fuss, an album that would soon become one of the most important releases of the decade, featuring hit songs such as Somebody Told Me, All These Things I've Done, So But I'm Not a Soldier, Smile Like You Mean It, and of course, Mr. Brightside. Now, although all these songs got big, Mr. Brightside still remains above the rest, as I'm sure you've no doubt been to a party and heard everybody lose their minds when that iconic guitar riff starts. How did this melancholy pop song come to be? Well, for this we have to go back to 2001, before the band even existed. See, at this time, lead singer Brandon Flowers had just been kicked out of his previous band, Blush Response, which is a fantastic name, and he was looking for like-minded musicians to work with. At a crossroads, he came across an ad posted in a Las Vegas newspaper by Dave Kuning, a 25-year-old guitarist who just moved to Vegas from Iowa a year earlier. The two met, and Dave showed Brandon a guitar track he'd been working on. But little did the two of them know that this track would end up becoming their biggest hit off their first record. The two began writing tons of songs together, and as Brandon recalled in a 2012 interview with NME magazine, quote, "That song came from this cassette of ideas that Dave gave me, and one of them was the Mr. Brightside riff. I was able to slap a chorus and some lyrics onto it, and I knew I liked it, but it wasn't until I first tried it out with a drummer that I knew it was something special. We went to this guy's house, showed him the song, and I got goosebumps after that." At this time, the drummer would have most likely been Matt Norcross, who was only with the band a short period of time in 2001, till he was fired and replaced by Ronnie Vannucci Jr. But I mean, enough about drummers. How did the lyrics for this hit come about? Well, Brandon continued by saying, quote, "Lyrically, it was about an old girlfriend of mine. All the emotions in the song are real. When I was writing the lyrics, my wounds were still fresh. I am Mr. Brightside. But I think that's the reason the song has persisted, because it's real. People picked up on those things, and that goes all the way down to the production. We recorded it in a couple of hours, but it just sounds right, you know? But what I find really interesting about this song is that the first and second verse are identical. And I always thought this was intentional, you know, to make the song more catchy or recognizable, but according to Brandon, it was actually due to him procrastinating. He couldn't think of any other lyrics, so he just stuck with the first verse and rolled with it. See, kids, so sometimes waiting to the last minute does work out. During 2002, the band played various shows in small venues throughout Vegas under the name The Killers, which was a reference to a logo used on the bass drum of a fictitious band portrayed in the music video for New Order's song Crystal. Around this time, the band also cemented a record deal with Island Records, who is a subset of Universal Music Group. The band then spent parts of 2003 recording the debut and set to release Mr. Brightside as the album's first single. The track received mild success upon first release, but it wasn't until it was re-released in 2004 that really hit big and received frequent plays on BBC Radio 1 by DJ Zane Lowe, as well as being played on XFM. And just 1 week after its release, MTV2 secured a deal to air the song for a week straight. Now, as I said before, Hot Fuss has had no shortage of hit songs, but part of me wonders if it wasn't for this song being the first single off the record, I wonder if the band would have hit it as big as they did, because to date, the song remains the UK's number 12th most downloaded rock track of all time, was named Song of the Decade by UK radio stations Absolute Radio and XFM, was voted 9th in the greatest guitar riffs of the 21st century so far by Total Guitar Magazine, and in 2012, Rolling Stone listed Mr. Brightside as the 48th best song of the 20th century. Plus, think about it. It's hard to find somebody that doesn't know every word to the song and won't hesitate to sing along to it as soon as that guitar riff starts. It's not far off to say that Mr. Brightside is probably the Wonderwall of the 2000s. And that's not saying anything bad about Wonderwall. What are your thoughts on Mr. Brightside? Let me know in the comments down below. My name's Elias Whitfield, and remember, it's all about the music, the history, and all the bits in between. Till next time.